From Minute Maid Park in Houston, Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. The Atlanta Braves taking on the Houston Astros. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready for baseball, towing the slab in today's game, Spencer Arrighetti.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance, so we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here, and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early, or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
Line drive, and that's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Kind of a risky pitch coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time. And now, let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
Here's Orlando Arcia. Right-hander kicks, deals. Hit on the ground, might be two. Altuve to second, on to Jose Abreu, that's two.
Sometimes double plays get turned so quickly that you don't really get to appreciate all of the finer details and how these guys execute them. Right there, really nice footwork, and a good feed to second was the key to pulling it off.
Here's Acuna now. Two outs. Now a screamer into the outfield. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. Half an incomplete. We've got no score. Back here at Minute Maid Park. And on the mound today, Darius Vines.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Bottom of the first. Here's Kyle Tucker. So now here's Kyle Tucker. Tucker, former fifth overall pick in the 2015 draft by the Astros. This guy's turned into a whale of a player. Off the plate and a count 2-1. Tucker hits for power. He's got 30 homer power, but the strikeout rate is under 20%. That one misses. And now three balls and a strike. Outside, and that is ball four.
Now, this was a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Jeremy Pena, the next to hit. That one off the bad part of the bat, just a lazy fly ball. Acuna makes the play.
That is good. No left field.
Now we check out the Astros lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These players have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. Tucker, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. And another ball. Ground ball, Olsen. Over to Arcia. That's one. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. On to the second inning now for Minute Maid Park. No score. Second inning set to go. Stepping in, Matt Olsen.
You almost have to feel bad for Matt Olsen after what happened in 2023. He played every game, hit 54 home runs, drove in 139, led the league in slugging, and he still wasn't even named a finalist for the National League MVP award.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Here's Austin Riley. One down, base is empty. Fought off foul. Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out. Here's Marcell Ozuna. In the air, right side of the infield. Altuve brings it in with a nice running grab. Braves go down quickly here. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here in Houston, standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Jose Altuve. This guy is an elite level hitter, especially considering contact, just the ability to hit for average. What you really like, though, stays in against those righties, and that's not so easy as a right-handed batter. The 1-1 is fouled off.
There's some players, for whatever reasons, they seem to just face a slew of right-handed pitchers, and their comfort level increased so much that they'd actually prefer to face that same side thrower in a tough situation.
The 2-2 now. Got him. One gone here.
Well, oftentimes that's the pitch he's trying to set up, the curveball. He'll lean on it pretty heavily, so you've got to be expecting it. Look for it and sell out so you don't miss it when you get it.
Here's Alex Bregman.
Inside.
That one misses. 3-1. Eric Summersgill with home plate duty in this one. Kind of known for being generous with the corners, Chris.
You know, I think that used to be a lot bigger deal in past eras where pitchers were working more in and out with their pitches. But, yeah, we'll see if those corners.
Pulled down the line. This one hammered, but it's foul. Of the pitch goes down looking for the strikeout. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
And welcome back to the ballpark. Well, here we go, top of the third, scoreless game. And the batter now, Adam Duvall. The wind of the pitch. And misses inside. Laced down the line. Could be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. It's a leadoff double to start the third.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. Check swing, did he go? Yes, he did. And a pitch. Got it by him. 4-0. So here's Murphy now. Murphy. And it's second. Got him lifted. Two gone now.
Most guys are very aggressive when they see the stakes out there on the base paths and can't understand why he wasn't ready to swing the bat. You've got to be ready to swing the bat in a situation like that with the go-ahead run in scoring position.
And he deals. Swung on, popped up on the infield. Breckman is under, and that'll do it. Braves strand one, and we are still scoreless. Back here in Houston, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the veteran first baseman, Jose Abreu. Now it's belted. Deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. He'll circle the bases, and just like that, they're out in front. It's 1-0.
The one thing the pitcher didn't want to happen just happened. That's not an easy one to stomach. He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
Here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. The pitch. Fastball in for a strike. It's 2-2.
Oh, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run. Go back to work. Focus on this next batter.
That one not close. And the count's full. Up first base side. Olsen settles under it. And it's caught for the out.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter. And a tough one at that.
Here's Mauricio Dubon. That's a strike. One out, base is empty. Struck him out without a swing. He's got to be frustrated with that call.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
Next offering upstairs. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That one back. Makes the catch up against the wall. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. And we're back as we go to the top of the fourth. And now Orlando Arcia. And that's a base hit.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
And here is Ronald Acuna Jr. And a count 1-2.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and hard the order coming up right behind them. This is where they need to get going.
The pitch. Grounder might be two. Over to Altuve. Two gone as they hit into their second double play in the first four innings.
As a former player, watching 5-4-3 double plays brings back some adrenaline. It's such an exciting play, and it's always a great reminder of baseball being such a team sport.
Matt Olson up to the plate. Two down, nobody on. Next pitch in for a strike. It's 2-2.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
That one in the dirt, and now 3-2. Austin Riley waiting on deck if they extend the inning.
Plenty of pop in his bat, so he could give them the lead with one swing if he gets the chance.
He goes down looking. Bottom four, and stepping in for the Astros, Jeremy Pena. And a 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Arcia under it. Two down.
Now back, second baseman, Jose.
Two outs, base is empty. Now a chance for Jose Altuve. Singing, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there.
Sends it to first, and they get Altuve for the out. Three up, three down, inning over. Nothing doing there for Houston, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Back here at Minute Maid Park, new inning getting started. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Austin Riley. And now it's 1-2. Wouldn't chase that time. Hard ground ball, base knock. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
So now to the plate for Atlanta, Marcell Ozuna. The 2-1. Rolled softly, but that goes foul.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Here's a 2-2. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for this team. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
Adam Duvall at the plate. And a pitch. Here's a high chopper. And it's just foul. That was close. Fouls it off. Still 1-2. The Braves trailing by a run. We're at the top of the fifth. Swing and he popped it off. He's under it. Squeezes it. Runner tagging for third. Applies the tag, and they get two. Double play. Ozzie Albies up to the plate.
Second base. Ozzie.
Ozuna leads off first with two down to the inning. Next pitch, not close, up high. Hit right side. Altuve slings to first. Third out, and that ends the frame. He continues to roll on the mound as five shutout innings are in the books. It's the Astros 1 and the Braves nothing. So coming into the game now on defense, Luis Guillorme. He's the new third baseman. And now it's Lead Alex up. Bregman.
Astros, the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
Here's a 1-1. That one fouled off. Hard hit left side. Throw on to Olson. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Now batting. Catcher, Yainer Diaz.
And next to hit for Houston, Yainer Diaz.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch.
Fly ball down the line. This has got a chance, and it is foul. Bases empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there are two outs.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
Just off the outside edge, and it's 2-1. Right through there for a strike. Two outs. Swings and misses, struck him out. Astros go down 1-2-3, but they still lead it 1-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Sean Murphy. The 1-1. Inside, just missed.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
And there's one down.
Up next for Atlanta, the center fielder.
Back to the top of the lineup. And now the center fielder, Michael Harris. The wide to kick the pitch. Curveball drops in for a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Pena calls it in, and there's two away.
Now batting.
And next for Atlanta, Orlando Arcia. Two down, nobody on, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Out to short, Pena. Tosses to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning for the Braves. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Astros 1 and the Braves nothing. Back here in Houston, bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick.
McCormick.
And the right-hander deals. And that is in for a strike. And the count, 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
There's a strike. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. And now the lineup turns over with one away.
The right fielder, number 30.
Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Kyle Tucker up next for the Astros. Tucker, who's been an all-star and a gold glover. Here's a 1-1. Runner on the go. Fouled off. He was late. Fly ball. Pretty well struck right field. Acuna. Will look back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Now batting. Shortstop. Jeremy Pena.
So next up for Houston, Jeremy Pena. That one close, ruled a ball. 2-1. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Ronaldo Lopez, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Lee also getting ready. The 2-1. That one missed.
Three balls, one strike.
Yeah. Next offering finds the zone of the count is full.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Base knock right field. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
The left fielder, number
nice
34.
Job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Falling behind, 2-1.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on. Two-ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Left-hand hitter waits. Crushed. Left center field. This one's deep. Forget it. And they throw three on the board. It's 4-0.
Already playing with the lead, and now they're celebrating a home run. They're having a great time out there. An impressive swing of the bat to go over the wall to the opposite field gap. And, you know, there are a lot of guys that just don't have the pop to do that, and probably just as many who don't have the approach either. He let that ball travel, and he got great extension on the follow-through to drive it out of here.
Ryan Snicker out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Darius Vines departs, and he had a tough time keeping them in the ballgame today. We'll get a new arm when we come back. Righty reliever out of the pen, Pierce Johnson. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Jose Altuve up to hit here. Two down, nobody on. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Hauls it in to end the inning. Houston brings in three on this homer. It's now a 4-0 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back here in Houston, here's Ronald Acuna Jr. at the plate.
Ronald Acuna Jr.
That's ripped. Base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
All over that one right there. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
And now 2-1. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. The 2-1. Right through there for a strike. Action in the pen down there. Rafael Montero, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Martinez getting loose as well. 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Had him out front for strike three.
Well, he used the slow curve very effectively right there. He just spun it up to the plate and had his guy way out front. Not only a good pitch, but a really good job of setting it up.
Here's Luis Guillorme. Righty delivers down the line, and that's a foul ball.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with the mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound. Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
Off-balance feed, there's one. Throw to first, but he beat it.
To play right there, didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Then at first, Marcelo Zuna will hit next. Swing and a pop-up. Pena moving under this one. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. One left for Atlanta. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. And we're back. Leading bottom of the inning. And stepping in for the Astros, Alex Bregman.
Alex Bregman.
Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. One away.
Up next for the Astros, the catcher,
Yainer. At the plate is the Astros Diaz. Catcher, Yainer Diaz. One down, base is empty. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
Jose Abreu up to hit. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo home run, but an important swing of the bat in this game. We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
And that's outside. Here goes the runner. Swing and a miss. The throw. Tag. And he's out.
Well, I think that was a hit and run right there. When you look at how far that pitch was out of the zone and the hitter still trying to put wood on it, put it in play, that tells you that they had something going. But unfortunately, it was a good job of execution by the pitcher and the catcher to get that out of the zone and then throw out the runner at second base. Really nice job behind the dish.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Harris makes the catch, and that'll do it. We go to the eighth, so here's the Braves' designated hitter, Adam Duvall.
Hitting is all about anticipation, and right now this lineup is struggling with it. Their swings are mistimed, and it's produced a few ugly cuts here and there.
And a pitch. And they'll do it again. And the righty deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The pitch. And now it's filled up.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
Two stays alive. The pitch tapped out in front of the plate. Altuve on the run sends it over to first. That was a strong at bat, even though he couldn't find a way on base. Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Spencer Arrighetti, done for the night, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with a new pitcher after this break. Rafael Montero, on a pitch out of the pen here.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Ozzie Albies next up for the Braves. On, One down, base is empty. Ripped on the ground a second. Gathers and throws to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
Now batter, the catcher, Sean Murphy.
Here's Sean Murphy. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Two down, nobody on. And we're in the top of the eighth. On the ground, right side, Altuve. The throw to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. And the Braves go down quietly. They trail it here 4-0. Bottom of the eighth, and now the center fielder, Chaz McCormick.
The center fielder, Chaz McCormick.
Pitch popped up. Arcia under it makes the catch for the out, and there's one away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Mauricio.
Now it's Dubon. The DH, Mauricio Dubon.
Come on,
kicks and fires. Pitch in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes. Base is empty, one away. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. Just misses. And it's 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Righty to the plate, and that's ball four.
Now batting.
So the Houston lineup turns over. Here's the Astros leadoff man, Kyle Tucker. The 1-1. That clips the corner. And another ball. And a pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. So up next, Jeremy Pena.
Shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Check swing, no appeal. Dubon, the runner at first with two gone. Got the bat going too soon at strike two.
Oh, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
Here's the 2-2. Got him swinging. One left for Houston, but they lead it 4-0. We go to the ninth. Now the leadoff spot for the Braves, Michael Harris. Left-hand batter waits. Headed down the line. Tucker really on his horse for it. And he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball. And here it comes. Wouldn't chase that time. Lifted in the air, right center field. Makes a nice grab at a full sprint. And there's one away.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
And that's in for a strike. That's off the inside edge. The count now 2-2. That one missing inside. Back to work. 3-2 now. Gets a piece and stays alive. Base is empty. One away here at the top of the ninth. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Right-handed reliever. In the dirt, two balls and a strike.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
The 2-1. Here's a swing and a drive, left field, and he knew it. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 4-2. They needed that one, Singy.
Indeed they did. They've been fighting to get back into this game, and just like that, they're back in it. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Ryan Abreu comes out trying to close it out.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Here is Matt Olson. Whoa. And another ball. Abreu, a very difficult guy to get hits off of. It's really rare for teams to string stuff together against him.
He wins every pitch, and for a hitter, sometimes a victory is just fouling off one of his pitches.
One strike.
Still only one out here in the inning. Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
Unless he beats himself, somehow can't find it, doesn't have the control and command that day, you can pretty much forget about it.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you get away with some of those, more margin for error. You know, the fastball becomes such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport. I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
The Braves down to their final strike. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
I don't care if you're a top team or you're a middle of the pack team. Every ball club wants to be dominant at home. Winning a game like this just helps to boost the confidence and makes you look forward to coming out again for the next one.
And your final 4-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shambi saying so long.
stands our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 4 runs on 5 hits. No errors. They left 2 runners on base.